Australia has 5.5 million baby boomers. But they don't all call Australia home.
Hello.
Hello. Come in.
Angela.
Hi, Angela. It's
so
lovely to meet you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Come through.
Norah Ault is one of a growing number of Australian retirees who've relocated abroad.
Sort of the living room, dining room, kitchen combined.
Up until 7 years ago, Norah lived in Perth, but she's chosen to spend her twilight years half a world away.
And this is the terrace off my bedroom.
Wow, look at this view. This is what you wake up to every morning.
Yes, it's lovely.
Ever get tired of it?
Never.
Never.
Her new home sits high in a historic hilltop village overlooking the olive groves of southern Spain.
I'm very fortunate to have this. I would never be able to have it in Australia.
It's lovely. Oh, that view would never get old.
Here we have 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, a study upstairs on the top floor for guests, and this level where we are now, which is the living room, dining room, kitchen. That's my house.
My gorgeous patio and garden, which I couldn't have if I lived in a city.
A big house and a comfortable middle-class life seemed impossible when Norah first retired from her Perth art gallery job on a single pension.
Oh, and I've got to show you my pantry.
I realised very quickly that there was no way with the superannuation that I had that I was going to be able to even afford a small one-bedroom apartment in the area that I wanted to live in.
You certainly couldn't drink like this back home
in
Perth.
No,
I would be living in poverty.
The best pantry in town.
Yes,
I concur,
absolutely.
I think.
I don't think I would have been able to afford to go to the theatre, to go to films, to eat lamb or beef. To have expensive heating in my house. To me, that is not how pensioners should have to live.
Norah found herself reminiscing about her happy year living in Madrid in the 60s. She started Googling and stumbled across a left-field solution to all her financial woes.
It was a big step. When I told my friends I bought a house in Spain, they thought, you know, what? So many of them said, that's fantastic. We're coming to stay.
Did anyone say, you're crazy?
Oh, yes, quite a few people said, you know, you're mad.
Norah bought her house in Martos outright for just $60,000 and spent another $40,000 on renovations.
Buenos dias.
Buenas.
¿Es posible un plato de jamón, por favor?
She secured a Spanish visa and arranged for her Australian pension in full to be deposited directly into a local bank.
Avocados here, only €2 for 4 avocados.
Norah's day-to-day living expenses are less than half what she'd pay in Australia.
I can afford the lifestyle that I would want to have in Australia, that I had in Australia when I was working. I can entertain my friends, I can go out and buy a case of wine, I can buy the sorts of meats that I want to buy, I can do everything I want to do.
Muchas gracias.
Sounds great, olive groves, vineyards, but maybe every day just sitting watching the vineyard is actually not the perfect retirement that we think it is.
Financial planner Brett Steen says that retiring overseas can be cost effective, but you have to do your research.
Be aware, of course, there's currency, so that goes up and goes down. So you are now living on that amount of money, which has a variation. So in her case also, I'd be thinking about, as you age, are you comfortable? Who's going to be looking after you? It sounds fantastic when you're healthy, but you have to be really conscious of when you get older, therefore what sort of care is required.
Again, Norah has hit the jackpot. Spain is ranked as having one of the best healthcare services in the world.
Hola, buenos días.
Better than the UK or the US, and private health cover is affordable.
$15.85.
I pay just over $2,000 a year. If I go to hospital or to the doctor, I don't have any extra to pay. It covers absolutely every penny, and that's for specialists, surgery, x-rays, everything.
Of course, Spain isn't all sunshine and sangria. Norah has faced some challenges along the way, including learning the language. But a crash course in Spanish yielded a whole new circle of friends.
Three here, this is a big one, isn't it?
Norah admits moving away from Australia was easier for her because she wasn't leaving any grandchildren behind. Now she's surrounded by children all the time. Older people are revered in Spain, and young folk are taught to treat them with the utmost respect.
Could you ever imagine having all of this anywhere in Australia?
Never, ever, ever in a million years.
And no regrets?
No regrets at all. None. None.
So you can't see any reason why you would move back to Australia?
No, none at all. No. This is my home and I will die here.
And your heart's happy with that?
My heart's very happy with that.